one of my board members said, oh, by the way, there's this virus in China that we don't know much about, but it might be a thing. Fast forward to today, and so many people have been involved, hundreds of centers around the world, hundreds of people around the world, to contribute their data to the COVID Critical Care Consortium.
I became aware of the COVID Consortium when it first started. John Fraser and I had met, you know, probably at one of the EuroELSO meetings that was in Australia a few years back. And it became very evident that this was a very needed thing.
I realized that I was part of something that had never happened in medicine, to my knowledge, before. And this is an example for how medicine should proceed in the future.
For John to bring it together so quickly and so comprehensively is the new thing, which I think has led to such a powerful research group. So it's a very impressive achievement, and I'm very lucky and proud to be part of it.
Really sharing experiences, sharing thoughts, perspectives, it's so critical and so important, and it's a multidisciplinary environment.
Nous avons besoin de la collaboration entre les amis pour pouvoir progresser dans les années qui viennent. This is what we need in the future.
What is unusual is this friendship, this amitié.
Oui, exactly.
But in other major medical research, this does not exist. This group are friends. We work together all the time for many years. It's only because we have this great group of friends, and you have to understand they're devoted to critically ill patients who are dying. And all the people in this room today were saying, well, it shouldn't be that way. They should be able to survive if we had a way to do it. So that's what it's about, and dear friends.
We think about each other as colleagues and friends, and we think about each other as a common people, and we think about the world as a place that we have to make better. So if that's not inspiring, I don't know what is.